most of us don't have to think twice about having a safe, secure place to live. But for some, the fight to have a decent home is a very real one. Well, Sarah Terry's film, A Decent Home, takes on the national housing crisis with a powerful story that is taking place right here at home.
Sarah, it's such an honor to have you here on Colorado & Company. Why is Denver Film Festival the perfect place for your world premiere?
Thank you so much for having us and for your interest in A Decent Home. Denver is the festival I always wanted to world premiere at because the main story in the film, it's a national film, but the main story is the story of the fight to save Denver Meadows Mobile Home Park in Aurora, Colorado. It was a 3-year battle, and that's the heart of the film. It follows the story of the park, and it follows the 2019 Aurora City Council elections, which were sort of the people who won were part of that, inspired by the fight at Denver Meadows. So it's a real Denver story. And for me, the heart of the film starts here. And it's important, I think, as a filmmaker, to let your film start where the story starts. And that's why Denver Film Festival is perfect.
I think that's so great. And it's just such an awesome story to be able to hear. I know I can speak for most Denver natives just like myself that this is something that is huge when it comes to our history. Now, this is also, like you said, a national story. What's happening in other states too?
So the story of mobile home parks and sort of greed around them, people selling them for lots of money or buying for lots of money, the private equity firms coming in, raising up lot rents so that people unlimited incomes can no longer afford to live in these parks. It's happening nationwide, and that's been going on for about the past 5 years. And the film tells a story in Iowa about a park that's been bought by a private equity firm where the lot rents, where you have your mobile home, went up by 63%. We go to a little park in New Hampshire, and we actually go to a park that's right next door to Google headquarters as a way of sort of saying, you know, this is an answer to the affordable housing crisis. These are affordable homes, and they're under threat because we don't care about them, for one thing, and because private equity firms are seeing a huge opportunity to make big money.
Huh. Yeah, I think this is really great. You're shedding light on something that's really important, like you said, that could be fixing a huge problem. And I'm so impressed with you, Sarah, too, because you started working on this film 6.5 years ago. I mean, what's changed since you began, and how timely is this story now?
Documentary filmmakers are nothing if not patient and persistent. So when I began working on this story, believe it or not, as I was writing grant proposals to foundations, I literally used the words the underreported affordable housing crisis. That's how much this wasn't on the country's radar. And for about 4 years, I worked on this quietly. I knew it was an issue. Warren Buffett owns the largest mobile home manufacturer. Sam Zell, who's a billionaire as well, owns more mobile home parks than anybody else. But in about the past 2 years, it started to catch on in the media. At the same time as the attempts of the private equity firms coming in to buy up homes in the market started. So John Oliver licensed some of my footage for a piece he did 2 years ago that had a big, big impact on the awareness of this. About 9 million people saw it. So I think the conversation, the problem is getting worse, but the conversation is also becoming more aware and activism is increasing.
Well, Sarah, this all sounds so amazing. I can't wait to see this film. This is the first documentary ever made about mobile home parks. I mean, what impact do you hope to have with this film?
You know, it's a 3-part impact that has been with me from the very beginning of the film. And the first was to break the stereotypes. You know, trailer trash is still kind of the one pejorative you can say about, you know, somebody who lives in America. We can't, it's the one name that's still acceptable. And I want to break that stereotype. I want to break the stereotype around who lives in these homes and what type of homes they are. And then the second part of it is I'm sounding a warning bell. I'm raising a red flag saying, yeah, these homes, which I've just hopefully tried to make you love a little bit, well, they're in danger because they're being bought up by the wealthiest of the wealthy. And then the third impact that I want to have is also part of the third part of the story where you literally see people rising up. They're fighting at a city council. They're fighting at a state house. You know, they're running for local elections, which is in fact where the most important change happens. So it's those three things, you know, break stereotypes, warn you, and boy, get you out of your seat and involved in your local community to be part of making change.
Well, Sarah, I think what you're doing is incredibly impactful and really important to shedding light on this important issue. And of course, shedding light too on the people who are really standing up, not just in their communities, but like you said, in the nation too. So Sarah, it's been such a pleasure and an honor to chat with you today. We can't wait to see your film.
Thank you so much. Looking forward to it. It's a big, big story all around Colorado.
The Denver Film Festival is back with 233 features, short films, and more. It's happening November 3rd through the 14th with the full slate of in-person screenings, red carpet, special presentations, as well as a robust offering of virtual screenings. Get your tickets at denverfilm.org. But if you just can't wait, well, I have a pair of tickets to give away right now. Email me at mycoco@9news.com and put movie in the subject line. Good luck, everyone.